Hello, my friends from YouTube. Today I'm gonna show you how to replace the keyboard and put back together this Dell Inspiron 11-3000 series. And this is the model. It's a Dell Inspiron 11-3000 series. And the model is P20T. Okay. Everything you do is in your own risk. I am not responsible for any damage that you cause to your devices. These are videos for education purposes only. Also, before you open any electronic device, you should wear one of these anti-static bracelets. Thank you. What happens with this computer is that they told me that they start having problems with the keys, and I find now when I tear down the computer that this cable is too short. When you connect it to the motherboard, it's just too short, and even it's not connected like 100% because it's too short. So and also when you remove the keyboard, these things go on the top, and then underneath it has some plastic connections like right here. All of this, see these little holes? All of these little holes, it has like a plastic that coming out, and it was like sealed, so that way the keyboard don't come out. So it is so hard to remove this keyboard. We need a lot of time. Then what I did is I used my solder machine to heat it up, each of them, and that way try to take it out. I was successful, so I already have the new part. Let me show you. So here is the new part. I gotta remove from the original the mouse pad and transfer to this new part, because the part that they sent me, this connection was broken. And also I already connected the keyboard, but and I glue in the corners. I put some glue in the corners because the pins, the plastic pins, some of them are broken. They sent me this part. We got broken plastic connectors. So, but I am the ones that I was there. So what I did is I pushed the keyboard like this, and then with my solder machine heat it up and try to seal it, so that way the keyboard doesn't move. So sorry. So right now, as you see, I replaced the keyboard, and now this plate was on the top, goes on the top of the keyboard, but like I said, the cable, it was too short because this part was on the way. So what I did, I just cut this part. It doesn't matter, because what we need this place for connect the motherboard and the other parts. The only thing we need from this plate is the screw holes. So I'm gonna put this, remember the plates go first and then the speakers. So let me show you this little part go under here, under this I think it's the audio connection right here. It go under, okay? So in like you see this one, it goes on the top here. This one goes on the top here, and you see little right here. You see this little like open connects to the one right here. Okay. So I'm gonna try to put it together, and then I will show you when it's done. I'm gonna pause the video so my video won't be too long. Okay, one more thing before you put this plate. You see these connections? We need to heat it up and try to make it connect with this plate. Let me see if I can do things. See? Yes. Hold on 1 second. You see right here? So you go with your solder. Okay, and then you have to do all of them. There's a lot of them around, so check and try to connect them, okay? So I'm gonna pause the video and I'm gonna do all of them. Make sure your solder station is 350, so that way it's not too hot and not too cold, like warm. Okay, I seal the plate with my heat gun, as you see. You can do it every place you have a chance to do it. Okay, now I'm gonna connect the speakers. Okay, the speakers go right here. Okay, and this one, here is the power button and volume button, so make sure this little plate go inside right here, because here are the buttons. Okay, power, volume up and down, okay. Okay, I don't know if you can see it, but see, this is the power. This is the volume. Okay. See, this one should be like lock here. Okay. Okay. Okay, and the speaker cables go here. You see these little hooks? So you go here, here. It's okay. And this little tape, I don't know why it's under the screw, but I put it back here. It's broken, so I just put a little piece of tape. Don't forget that this cable goes under this plate, okay? From here is the audio cable, goes here under the plate. Okay, now I'm gonna connect, I'm going to install the motherboard, but make sure the CPU is clean. We use alcohol, pure alcohol, not mixed with water. If it is too dry, like in my case, use a brush to, and be careful, do not damage the microchips around, okay? Okay, now it's clean. Okay, let's connect the antenna, wireless antenna. It's the smallest screws of the computer. Then I'm going to install this motherboard for the antenna, battery, USB, SIM card. Okay, then we're gonna install the motherboard, but we have to make sure the CPU sink cover is clean. Okay, now we are gonna add thermal paste to the CPU. Just a little bit. Okay, that's enough. That's enough. Just tie one a little bit, then the other one a little bit. Don't tie one screw the whole way. Okay, let's connect the cables. These ones was like this. Make sure you pull the black connectors out. And then push Looks fine. So here looks like it's not. And then let's connect this one to this motherboard. Okay, this one was here, this is the for the fan. Okay. Let's connect these speakers. Looks good so far. Also make sure the magnetics are sticked over here. Here is one more speaker cable over here. Okay. Now let's connect the hard drive. Let's go slow here. Okay, let's connect it. Okay. Okay, let's connect this cable that goes from the motherboard, MB motherboard, to the mousepad. Leave the clip, push it, same here, leave this clip, push it, okay. Sometimes I put tapes, but I need it. So when you open a computer, then okay. Now let's connect the screen. This is called like this. Okay. Make sure this cable goes under here, and also these little cables for the wireless antenna. And we're gonna use these screws for. here. Okay, so you put the screw here. There is a little arrow here and here, because these covers go here, and we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 screws. Okay. So now let's connect the screen. The screen has 2 cables, this one and this little one that goes here. Okay, see, lift the clip and push the cable and then close it, and then this tape goes here. Okay, so let's connect the wireless antenna. See, the white score and the white black go here. Okay, be careful when you connect this one, because if you break the connector from the antenna, you need to buy a new one. Okay, let's connect the battery. Make sure this cable is on the top. Okay, we need one more screw here. Okay. I'm not sure, but I think these 2 magnets goes here. Okay, this little plate goes the top right here. Okay. Two screws. These cables go here. Okay. Attached to the barrel. So now let's put the cover back. And we need 9 screws, okay? Make sure you close it very well before you before you put the screws back. So now it's ready. Put the screws. Don't tie the whole way, just a little bit at a time each one. Okay, looks good so far. Finish. You see, everything closed well and open. So it has the new keyboard. I am going to remove this sticker, this one, and place it here. And this one too. Okay. Okay, guys, my charger is not good. It's bended over here, so it's not working anymore. I need to order a new one. But anyway, that's the way you put together a Dell Inspiron 11 3000 series. Model P20T. Okay, thank you for watching my videos. Hope you like it, and give me like, subscribe, check my other videos. Thank you.